read.
I
Well, let's stay with the Municipal a little bit, because the Municipal and the ballot issue in Montgomery has quite a few problems. The worst problem is letting the electric system out. And all you have to do is watch their behavior. Who are you going to hand for the Seahawks? If they do the Seahawks, and you don't like it, or if they don't do the Seahawks, and you don't like it, they do, who are you going to hand for? You can't blame Jerry Locke, you can't blame, anybody except yourself. And so there's the chain of responsibility on an issue like that. Income tax and the tax system of this state is a fraud. It's the worst in the United States. It's the most progressive. It's the hardest on poor people and business people who. It's a terrible tax system. Can we change it? Of course not, because nobody has the courage to actually do it. They think, for example, they hide behind the claim that you have to go to the people in order to get an income, to stay income. That doesn't happen to be true, but they hide behind it, you see. And you know what happened in that ballot, you pronounce the very thing. Shortly after he was elected, he took him 4 years to recover from. That isn't the people's bill at all. And the people don't vote for it. I was involved in income tax issues twice when we were involved. The pro-income tax votes came from Baltimore, Washington Park, the Highlands, wherever. The anti votes came from Wallingford and the Central Area. And that's what happened. The people voted against their interests on that issue. The narrowest economic. And so, that's where we are. So the vote, it's a very difficult process. It's worked well. One of the things that greenhouse gas taught me something, he taught me something, he said that neutral was a special kind of organization, probably preventable, not one directly elected public official, because it's a technical agency. It kind of needs to be run by a city manager. But he said it was essential that they voted a ballot every 2 or 3 years with some expensive program to get the people to vote on it as a kind of ratification of their. I think the people vote quite well. They don't always agree with me, and sometimes they don't agree. But basically, there's an intelligence. I've been involved in breaking the campaign. And I can only see an intelligence breaking, especially when you put 7 or 8 on the Charter Amendments that was 15 Charter Amendments. The votes were pretty interesting. They both say more on how it went, but there was quite a bit of discriminating. You could see an intelligence agreement. And I believe that's true. I think people vote for it in the new factor question is the paid signature drivers and the new politics, the community-based politics. Those two things are very different.
Speaking of the president, in 1997, he was even people like Brewster Denny, who was very popular today, and Thomas Ross, which is clearly a huge hire, very significant government, and they feel pretty good about that. And that's an unfortunate situation that was jumping back to 1979, when the Pike Place Market Initiative really seemed to access to the very important story. Very important. Because it was one to one, face to face.
Something that you're already
the levees. So, but there's a very good spirit, a lot of people talk about the spirit of preservation, and the Lord's Prayer, we ran in 67 and 69, we ran two sets of television lines for the city of Seattle, which turned the city government old-fashioned, dominated system into a strong mayor system, and which changed the face of the city from a really bright, against all blacks. I have people campaigning against me in 1967 Charter Amendment campaign because I wanted, so they said, to bring black people on the police force. And later, one of those people asked himself, was elected to the district against that because of the affirmative action aspects of it. He used the word with me, and he said, that's what you're trying to do, isn't it? And he said, well, I don't use that word, but you got it right. And so that,
how did that change from government?
Well, we created a strong mayor system, which we have not had before. It's an interesting thought. Once in a while, it strengthens a person's Brian Dabrowski or Frank
That wasn't
exactly what it's for.
That was what? That was the plan.
That's right. Clearly now, with a much larger historical preservation community, it does have a
we got 40 minutes.
I guess the last question I'll ask is the one that came up to the state of the process in the state of Oakland. And it's kind of a summary view of could that initiative process that saved the market in 1979 happened in
1979.
Just professors.
But professors help. They help a lot. I know that in the several charters, Professor Denny, I mean, that could help. I mean, he knows. In my field, there's American foreign policy. I don't know about city charters, but they don't talk to it. But, you know, that's the in transfer, the expertise that was available to us was with very strong because they look at the numbers. They get the numbers. You don't really have the numbers to look out and look at the cars and then look at the way people are doing places. I think that
the numbers never would have a lot of
important. Or Washington, D.C. or San Francisco. I think that two things. One, the lack of sensible public transportation. And two, the preservation of the industry. You get 6 or 8 miles outside of London, having already been in some beautiful parks, downtown parks. You go 6 or 8 miles out of London, you're on the country. And it's beautiful. And people living there, they see.
Well, Professor,
is that the whole thing?
I think that's enough.